Good morning, students. Today is 6th April. Today we are going to start with the last properties of alcohol, that is type 3 property. Till now discussed two chemical properties of alcohol. The first one was in which during the reaction carbon oxygen bond breaks. Second one was the reaction in which the OH bond breaks. Now we are going to discuss the third category reaction as listed on the blackboard. So today we are going to discuss type 3, category 3 property. Reaction during which both are alkyl group and OH will participate. That is, we have a general formula R OH. During this category reaction, this will also participate and this will also participate. In this, we are going to discuss three properties. The first one we are going to do is reaction with concentrated sulfuric acid. We are going to do a reaction we have done in 11th class called dehydration. That is removal of water. Second one we are going to discuss is called dehydrogenation. Dehydrogenation means removal of hydrogen. D in chemistry means removal. And the third one we are going to discuss is called oxidation. So in today's class, we'll be discussing these three reactions which belong to this particular category. Which category? In which both R as well as OH will participate. So let us see one by one these three properties. So the first property we are going to discuss is called dehydration, removal of water. So we are discussing dehydration. Dehydration means removal of water, removal of HOH. It is an example of a beta elimination reaction. Beta elimination reaction means in which the two groups are removed from adjoining carbon. Two groups are removed from adjoining carbon. Now in this reaction, if you see the reactivity, the order of reactivity, in dehydration reaction, the most reactive would be tertiary alcohol. It loses water very, very easily, followed by secondary alcohol, so in the third category we are starting with the first reaction. This is called dehydration of alcohol. Dehydration of alcohol gives you the formation of alkene. What is dehydration? As I have already told you, it's loss of water. Now in this reaction, tertiary alcohol undergoes loss of water very quickly, followed by secondary alcohol, followed by primary alcohol. Means with this, the rate of the reaction is very fast, then secondary alcohol, and the primary alcohol will undergo dehydration very, very slowly. As you can see, it is evident from the reaction conditions. Suppose you've got a primary alcohol. If you want it to undergo dehydration, we have to use concentrated sulfuric acid and 443 Kelvin temperature. And what is going to happen when you heat this alcohol with Kong esters with 443 Kelvin? from one carbon OH will go away, from the adjoining one H will go away, OH and H goes away, and you get a double bond between them. You get the formation of ethene. If you are using a secondary alcohol, as you can see on the blackboard, propane toluol, instead of sulfuric acid, even it goes with phosphoric acid, slightly low temperature, 440 Kelvin. Again, what is going to happen? OH from one carbon, NH from another carbon. And you know, when the two groups are removed from the adjoining carbon, it is called as a beta elimination reaction. This is an example of a beta elimination reaction, and you have a double bond over here. So you get the formation of propene. If you're having a tertiary alcohol, you can even go for the milder condition and even a milder acid. Instead of 85%, you can go for 20% phosphoric acid. Again, from one carbon, OH will go, and the H from the adjacent one. Even you can remove H from here or from here. Doesn't matter, you will get the same product. So OH, H gone, and you get a double bond. You get a formation like this. This compound is called 2-methylpropene. So these three reactions prove to you that primary alcohol undergoes dehydration slowly, secondary alcohol undergoes dehydration slightly quickly, and tertiary alcohol undergoes dehydration very, very quickly, even under milder condition. Milder, slightly drastic, and very, very drastic. So that these three reactions prove the above reactivity order. In this reaction, the elimination reaction, I need to revise a rule that you have already done in your 11th class. That's called Sedziff rule. Sedziff rule. You know what is Sedziff rule says? That during elimination reaction, hydrogen is removed from that carbon. We remove hydrogen from that carbon which already has lesser number of hydrogen, If you remember, in 11th class, we used to use the word poorer becomes poorer with respect to hydrogen. We remove mainly hydrogen from that carbon, which already has less number of hydrogen. For example, look at this equation. Suppose we have got butane toluol. We want it to undergo dehydration. So we use concentrated sulfuric acid. We heat it to high temperature. Very simple in this compound. Any guesses from where you will remove OH? This is the carbon from where the OH will get removed, because that is the carbon which has got an OH. No other carbon has an OH. So from this carbon you remove OH. From the adjacent carbon you have to remove OH. Now adjacent to this carbon we have got this carbon as well as this carbon. This has got three hydrogens. This has got two hydrogens. So mainly the hydrogen will be removed from this carbon. So the major product will be OH, NH will go from like this, and you have a double bond between them. So the main major product that you're going to get is the most substituted alkene that we have out of the two possibility, bute-toluene. This will be your major product obeying Sedziff rule. Poorer becomes poorer. And in one or two molecule, even this will happen. You have OH and H going from here. So you will have a minor product that will be bute-toluene in a very, very less amount. Those of you know hyperconjugation, out of the two alkenes which are possible, this one is more stable. And in the reaction, we get only the products which are more stable. So that's an application of a rule called Sedziff rule, valid in the case of elimination reaction. Poorer becomes poorer. We remove hydrogen from that carbon which already has less number of hydrogen. Poorer becomes poorer. Now let us do two conversion based on this particular reaction called dehydration reaction. Mainly this is used to convert alcohol into alkenes. They are used in the preparation of alkenes. We have done this in class 11th in the preparation of alkene. Let us see two conversion. Suppose they have to, they have asked you to convert propane 1-ol. You have to convert into propane 2-ol. If you draw the structure which is mandatory, which should be done first of all whenever you ask conversion, write on the structure. If you draw the structure, you will find you have to remove OH from the first carbon and you're going to put on the second carbon. So naturally when you have to change the position of the group, first of all you have to remove the group and then add. So it is elimination followed by addition. So we take propane 1-ol, we react it with conch H2SO4, heat it to very high temperature. From this carbon, OH will go. From the adjoining one, hydrogen will go. First of all, you will get propene. Now, propene to all is a Markovnikov product. We want OH on this carbon with the less number of hydrogen. So we simply add water, hydration, in the presence of acid. We'll get a Markovnikov product. OH will add to the carbon with less number of hydrogen, and you will get a Markovnikov product, that is propene to all. Now let us do the vice versa. Let's try to convert propane to all. Let's convert into propane 1-ol. So again, it will be elimination followed by addition. We'll take propane 2-ol. Heated with high temperature, conch H2SO4. Heated to high temperature. From one carbon, OH will go. From the adjacent carbon, H will go. And you will get the formation of propene. Now you want to put OH on the first carbon. So we are looking for anti-Markovnikov product. For anti-Markovnikov product, you know, alkene into alcohol, we need hydroboration. So it will be B2H6, the first step. You can mention like this, you don't have to show the mechanism. And oxidize with hydrogen peroxide in the basic medium. Net result, OH will be added to the first carbon. So the main product that you're going to get is propane 1-ol. So this is how we can use dehydration to change the position of the OH group. 1-to-all and 2-to-1. Now we need to discuss the mechanism of this reaction also. We'll take the example of dehydration of ethanol once more and illustrate the mechanism. You will find mechanism involves the carbocation. So let us discuss the mechanism for dehydration of ethanol. Mechanism for dehydration of ethanol. First of all, let's write down the reaction. That is dehydration of ethanol. Let us write the reaction. This is ethanol. Heated with conch H2SO4, high temperature, concentrated sulfuric acid, 443 Kelvin. OH from here gone. You get the formation of ethene. You can see basically it is a reverse of hydration. You're done in the preparation of alcohols. When you hydrate, acid catalyzes hydration of alkene, you get alcohol. If you dehydrate, you get back alkene. So let's see the mechanism. It involves three steps. First step, which is a fast step. So in this, what is going to happen is, first of all, sulfuric acid is going to dissociate to give H+. Now ethanol on oxygen has a lone pair of electron, something negative. So it is going to pick up H+. Addition of H+ to alcohol. Addition of H+ is nothing but called protonation. So alcohol gets protonated, and this is a fast protonation of alcohol. What do we get is CH3, CH2 with a plus charge. Protonation of alcohol takes place. That is the first step, and it is a fast. Second step is the slowest step. In this, protonated alcohol is going to lose water. This bond breaks like this. Bond breaking needs energy, and that's why it is a slow step. So this is the slow step. You get the formation of the carbocation. This is a carbocation. You know what is a carbocation? Carbon with a plus charge. Now last step which is going to happen is this carbocation is going to lose H plus. Loss of H plus is called deprotonation. From the adjacent carbon, the carbon with the plus charge, the adjacent carbon to that is going to lose H plus. Who will accept this H plus, which is coming out, will be accepted by HSO4 minus, formed in the first. So like this, the two electrons will come like this. You get the formation of ethene. This H plus coming out will be accepted by HSO4 minus, converts into H2SO4. So in this overall mechanism, second step is a rate determining step. It is a slowest step. And you can just see why it is a slowest step. It involves breaking of this bond, which is a very, very strong bond. So this is the mechanism for dehydration of ethanol. You can practice the same mechanism for dehydration of propane-1-ol. You can do the mechanism for dehydration of propane-1-ol. You should try. Same steps. Only you have to increase one carbon. So this was a mechanism for dehydration of ethanol to form alkene. Previously we had done one more mechanism, that was acid catalyzed hydration of ethene to ethanol. It was just the reverse of ethanol into ethene. Reverse of hydration. So this was the first reaction called dehydration. Now we are going to discuss second reaction of this category, that is dehydrogenation. As I told you, dehydrogenation means loss of hydrogen. Don't you think so? We can call it as an oxidation also. Now you will find in this reaction, the primary alcohol is going to behave in a different manner. This is a primary alcohol. It's going to behave in a different manner. Secondary alcohol is going to behave in a different manner. This is an example of secondary alcohol. And tertiary alcohol is going to behave in an entirely different manner. We are going to remove hydrogen from all these components. This is an example of a tertiary alcohol. So in the case of primary alcohol, if you want to remove hydrogen, you need to heat with copper. Temperature 573 Kelvin. Same happens with the secondary alcohol. Heat it with copper at a high temperature. Tertiary alcohol again, you heat it with copper 573. Now we are going to remove hydrogen, two hydrogens, one from oxygen, one from adjoining carbon. So primary alcohol, when you heat with copper 573, one hydrogen is lost from oxygen. This will go away. And one from adjoining carbon, this H will go away. So what are you left with? R. CHO. I think everyone can recognize this is nothing but a compound called aldehyde. So primary alcohol on losing hydrogen changes into corresponding aldehyde. Remember, we are discussing in the preparation of alcohol, if you reduce aldehyde, you get primary alcohol. If you remove hydrogen from primary alcohol, you're going to get aldehyde. Now let's remove hydrogen from here. So where are the two hydrogens being lost? One from oxygen, one from adjoining carbon. And you have a double bond between them. So what you will get is, you can make up, you get a ketone. So secondary alcohol on dehydrogenation, you get the formation of ketone. Now what happens in the case of tertiary alcohol? It cannot lose hydrogen. Let's see why. You can remove hydrogen from oxygen, but the adjoining carbon doesn't have a hydrogen. It doesn't have a hydrogen. So it cannot lose two hydrogen. So what happens is, if you heat tertiary alcohol with copper 573, it doesn't undergo loss of hydrogen. it undergoes loss of water, HOH. So from this carbon, OH will go. From the adjoining carbon, H will go. And on dehydration, not dehydrogenation, that is not possible over here, we get the formation of alkene. Neither aldehyde nor ketone, we get the formation of alkene. So in the primary alcohol, two hydrogens are lost, we get an aldehyde. Two hydrogens are lost, we get a ketone in the case of secondary alcohol. Tertiary alcohol, hydrogen cannot be lost. It will go from here, there is no hydrogen over here. So it undergoes dehydration and you get the formation of alkene. So suppose they ask you a question, how primary, secondary, tertiary alcohol behave differently in a reaction called dehydrogenation. You can mention primary alcohol on losing two hydrogens gives you corresponding. Corresponding means the same number of carbon atom into an aldehyde. Secondary alcohol gives you a ketone and tertiary alcohol gives you an alkene. It doesn't undergo dehydrogenation, the tertiary alcohol, it undergoes dehydration. It cannot undergo dehydrogenation because the adjoining carbon doesn't have a hydrogen. Now let us do some questions based on this particular reaction. First of all, very simple ones, like they may ask you to convert butanol alcohol into butanal. That is an aldehyde. Suppose we want to convert pentane 2-ol, again an alcohol, into pentane 2-one, that is a ketone. They may ask you to convert, let's say, benzyl alcohol into a compound called benzaldehyde, that is an aldehyde. Remember what was benzyl alcohol? It's not a phenol. Benzyl alcohol, I told you, was benzene with CH2OH. So in this, all these conversions, we have to convert into an aldehyde or a ketone. You can write one step. No need to show how the reaction is happening. You can write copper 573, copper 573. So whenever you have to convert an aldehyde into, alcohol into aldehyde or a ketone, you can go for the reaction called dehydrogenation reaction. Now I show you an interesting conversion, which is slightly more than two step. Suppose they ask you to convert ethanol with two carbon, ethanol, into a favorite ketone, acetone. You know what is acetone? Three carbon ketones, CH3, COCH3. This is a step-up reaction. You need to increase the number of carbon atoms. What is ethanol? CH3, CH2OH, two carbon alcohol. Now, if you want to increase the number of carbon atoms, the reaction that should come to our mind is Grignard reagent. Only problem is that Grignard reagent, when it reacts with an alcohol, it becomes alkene. But if you want to convert into a ketone with more carbon, first of all, ethanol has to be converted into ethanol. So you heat it with copper 573. I'm using dehydrogenation reaction. 2H gone. You will get CH3CHO. You get an aldehyde. Then we reacted with Grignard reagent. CH3MgBr. Why CH3MgBr? Because we have to increase one carbon. And we have already done, when you react ethanol with CH3MgBr, the alcohol that you are going to get is propane 2-ol. So we increased carbon by one. But if we don't want alcohol, we want a keto. So again, we can go for dehydrogenation, copper 573. The two hydrogens will be lost and you get a formation of ketone. So this was a nice conversion where you can convert ethanol into acetone. Ethanol into acetone. Ethanol into acetone. Now for the practice sake, you can try these two conversions. They're based on this type of step only. Like you can convert benzyl alcohol into a compound called acetophenone. It would be the same steps, only the compounds are different. You know what is benzyl alcohol? benzene with CH2OH. And some of you may be knowing what is acetophenone. Acetophenone is benzene. COC. Again, you can see we have to increase one carbon. So you can follow the same steps. You will get the answer. On the parallel lines, we can convert propane to all. We can convert into 2-methyl propane to all. Draw the structure, you will get the hint. This is what is propane to all. And this is what we are looking for with one carbon extra. So again, you need to follow the above steps only. Only thing is that you will stop over here. Don't make it into ketone. You won't be able to make it because as tertiary alcohol, you have just seen that if you subject this to dehydrogenation, you won't get a ketone, you will get an alkene. So you first of all subject this to this step, you get a ketone, then add grand reagent, and you will get 2-methylpropane-2-ol. So this was a beautiful combination of dehydrogenation and then reaction with the Grignard reagent, which you know is nothing but we have done already. It is a nucleophilic addition reaction. So this was the second reaction called dehydrogenation. The first one we have discussed was dehydration, loss of water. This is dehydrogenation, that is loss of hydrogen. Now we are going to discuss the third reaction and the last reaction for the day, that is oxidation of alcohol. We can do oxidation with the mild reagent. We can use mild oxidizing agent. Mild oxidizing agents will be able to oxidize primary alcohol and secondary alcohol, not the tertiary alcohol. And then we are going to go for the strong oxidizing agent. The strong oxidizing agent that we'll be using will be potassium permanganate. We can use in the acidic medium. You can go for the basic medium also. So KMnO4 in the acidic medium. KMnO4 in the acidic medium. The milder ones we can use is anhydrous chromium trioxide. This is a mild oxidizing agent which will oxidize primary alcohol as well as the secondary alcohol. Will not be able to oxidize ketone. We'll be using a very important reagent called PCC. The full form is pyridinium chlorochromate. Pyridinium chlorochromate. If you want to see the formula, otherwise you can just write PCC only, that is suffice. But the formula is as follows: C5H5NH, the positive part, and the negative part is CrO3Cl. This is the negative part. So if we can use PCC, stands for pyridinium chlorochromate. Another one is anhydrous chromium trioxide. So first of all, let's see what happens when we use mild oxidizing agent. As I told you, mild oxidizing agent is going to oxidize primary alcohol as well as the secondary alcohol, not the tertiary alcohol. You will find the reaction will be same because I have already told you oxidation is also loss of hydrogen, and we have just seen what happens when a primary alcohol or secondary alcohol loses a hydrogen. We did with copper 570. The same product will happen over here. So this is primary alcohol and this is secondary alcohol. Let's say we are reacting it with PCC. I need to use a solvent, dichloromethane. I'll be using dichloromethane. So PCC, what is PCC stands for? Pyridinium chlorochromate. And I'm going to use dichloromethane. Same thing will happen, loss of two hydrogens. You're going to get the same compound, aldehyde, corresponding aldehyde. Loss of two hydrogen, you're going to get the formation of keto. And as I told you, instead of this PCC, we can use anhydrous CrO3 also. If you use tertiary alcohol, mild oxidizing agent will not be able to use, oxidize the tertiary alcohol. Now let's see what happens with a strong oxidizing agent. Strong oxidizing agent can oxidize both primary alcohol, secondary alcohol, tertiary alcohol, all of them. But in our course, we'll be discussing only oxidation of primary alcohol. The oxidation of secondary and tertiary alcohol will not be mentioned. So let's see what happens when you use strong oxidizing agent. Strong oxidizing agent. What is an example of strong oxidizing agent? KMnO4 in the acidic medium. So suppose we take a primary alcohol. We oxidize it with KMnO4 in the acidic medium. First step, same thing, loss of two hydrogens. So these two hydrogens will go away. You know, when primary alcohol loses two hydrogen, what does it convert into? An aldehyde. You get an aldehyde. The two hydrogens will go, double bond, you get an aldehyde. Now the reaction will not stop over here. It will go on one step further. Further undergo oxidation. We'll have addition of oxygen over here. This bond will break and the oxygen will add up over here. So what you get is RC double bond O and OH. This is none other than carboxylic acid with the same number of carbon atom. If you remember, we've already discussed in the preparation of alcohol, carboxylic acid, if you reduce with lithium aluminum hydride, you get primary alcohol. This reaction is just the reverse of what we have done in the preparation of alcohol. If you take primary alcohol, you put KMnO4H+, you're going to get carboxylic acid with the same number of carbon atom. You can write it in one step also. You can write directly primary alcohol into carboxylic acid. For example, if they ask you to convert propanol and you want to make it propanoic acid, so we can write KMnO4H+, and directly you can write that we get propanoic acid. So primary alcohol non-oxidation with a strong oxidizing agent, we get carboxylic acid with the same number of carbon atom. So in today's class, we have discussed the type 3 property of alcohol. That was the last chemical properties of alcohol. We'll wind up alcohol tomorrow. We have to do the chemical test of alcohol also. That we'll do tomorrow. Today what we have discussed was the property in which both R and OH was participating. We did three reactions. Number one was dehydration with concentrated sulfuric acid. We did the mechanism also. Second one that we have discussed was dehydrogenation, loss of two hydrogen. And this is the third one that we discussed, that is called oxidation. Thank you. That's all for today's class. See you tomorrow. Take care. Bye.